Hello and welcome to our brand new sports show here on CUTV every 2 weeks.
Coming up, we'll be showing you what happened at the first ever Cassidian Cup down at Cardiff Farms Park. We'll be talking to Cardiff Sportswoman of the Year, Natalie Evans, and we'll be profiling the Redhawks Cardiff Ice Hockey team.
But first, Alan, Nadia and Melissa went along to the recent press conference of the Wales versus Macedonia game and heard from manager Chris Coleman. Let's hear what he had to say.
Whether I like it or we like it or not, you always judge on results. Simple as that. So that's how it's always been, that's how it'll always be. I know we're both obviously still there regarding the contract situation, but I don't think it's the time or place for that. We've got to concentrate on Friday night, playing Macedonia, and try and achieve a result. That's the biggest thing. I've said before, I'm here till the end of the campaign. Do what happens after that and what the outcome will be, will be. And I'm sure enough, soon enough, we'll find out. But I'm not thinking about that really. I'm thinking about Macedonia. And then a quick turnaround, we've got Belgium, who is a standout team. Job in hand, Macedonia. How do we prepare? Who's our strongest 11? What change may we need to make? That's as far as I'm looking at. I think he's approaching 80 caps, so that's a good shift. We need more and more players up there, and to surpass that. I want to see our players reaching 100 caps, like some of the other countries have got. And some of our boys will have a chance to do that. They're at a great age, so if they've got a bundle of caps, and if they keep marching on, they can surpass that. I think Craig's made the right decision. In the corner of the day now, being a good servant. The next campaign will be a tough one, no doubt. If you look at him with Cardiff at the moment, he's playing here and there. And that just comes to everybody, that's the age. Wear and tear, simple as that. So he's been a good servant. He's fit in that. It's his last game for Wales at home is in Cardiff, it's his hometown in front of his crowd. So I'm sure you enjoy the night. Yeah, I said in my last press conference, it's all right having a pool of talent. Having a pool of talent available to play games is two different things. And there was being said about this is the best bunch of players. I think Bella said it since 1958. Well, I wouldn't necessarily agree with that. I think you have a Southalls and you have Kevin Radcliffe and Ian Rushes and Mark Hughes and Dean Saunders, you are engaged, you've got young guys' speed coming through. Hell of a bunch of good players that. We've produced some good teams, we've just never done it. And these boys have got potential. But we've got to have them available so they can fulfill that potential. That'll be the main thing. Players are there. We need them here and we need them on the pitch. Ultimately that's what we need to do. Nothing prepares you really for international football. It doesn't matter whether you're playing Premier League football. Nothing prepares you for international football. You need to be there, experience it, and you can deal with it or you can't. Cope with how tough it is or you can't. And you only get better at it with experience, unfortunately. And sometimes that's not easy. Sometimes you have to, it's a tough learning curve. But if you come through it, and you stick at it, then you can be a good international performer.
That was Chris Coleman speaking on Thursday. Since then, Wales managed to beat Macedonia 1-0 and grind out a hard-fought draw against Belgium, but his managerial position is still on the line.
Now let's take a look at the first ever Cassidian Cup down at Cardiff Arms Park. This included four teams made up of Cardiff University, Cardiff University Medics, the University of South Wales and Cardiff Met. A team of us went down, so let's see how they got on.
Thank you. You're squeezing the blood from a stone. Oh. Wash away the ashes from today. Wash the rest of the sea and sharpen the dead. To the background in black and white. That's the way it's always been. That's the way it's gonna end. All the world fell silent when I read the verdict. Be sure you can count on your friends. Oh. Wash away the ashes from today.
So that was the footage from the Cassidian Cup. Unfortunately, Cardiff University narrowly missed out in the final to Cardiff Met, coming a close second.
In other news, Natalie Evans recently won gold at the European University's Judo Championship.
She's also currently our Cardiff Sportswoman of the Year. I caught up with her earlier.
Hi, I'm Nadia and I'm currently here with Natalie, our Sportswoman of the Year for Cardiff, for CUTV. So currently you're on the Cardiff University High Performance Academy.
Yeah.
And so how do you fit that in around your studies? Do you find it difficult? Do you do so much training?
It is quite hard. We train over in Fair Gardens like three times a day, judo and weights and conditioning sessions, and then doing a full-time course as well. It's really hard, to be honest. Literally don't have time for anything else. But
so what year are you in at the moment?
I'm in my final year now, but I've kind of done it sort of part-time. I did my first 2 years and I had a gap year. I went again for another year, and now I'm going to do my last year over 2 years. So I'm spreading it out a little bit because it's too much. I can't
make it a little bit easier for you. So you were in the summer you're in Portugal and you won a gold medal, is that correct?
Yeah, just a couple of weeks ago we just come back from the European universities. So they took all the winners of the British universities, went out to Portugal to compete. So.
Must be rewarding after all that hard work that you've been doing over here. So at the moment you're currently aiming for the Commonwealth, is that right?
Yeah, that's my first aim. That's now in, I think, the end of June next year, or July possibly. That's my next aim, and then hopefully get a medal in Worlds and Europeans. So those are my three main targets for next year.
So are you going to be stepping your training up even more for that, or?
I train quite a lot already. I just train just equally as hard. But that's my main goal for the next few months, I suppose.
So have you got any competitions coming up anytime soon around Cardiff, or is it just travel quite a long way to?
Yeah, most competitions you've got to travel a lot at the moment. I think the next one is Abu Dhabi at the end of November. We've got an Asian tour with the British team, so we go to Japan, Korea, and Abu Dhabi in 3 weekends. The only problem is I miss 3 weeks, so you need to do it. But
so a lot of travelling around then.
Hopefully, because I've spread it now over 2 years, my final year, it'll be more easy to manage. That's what I'm hoping anyway. Hopefully I'll get a degree at the end as well.
I'm sure you'll manage it. Well, good luck for everything.
Thank you.
And hope it all goes well.
Now we'll be taking a look at Cardiff Redhawks ice hockey team. Every show, we'll be taking a look at a different sport and profiling them, having a look at what goes on.
Hugh and Adam recently went down to the Cardiff Ice Arena at a rather late hour to check them out.
Hi, we are here inside Cardiff's Planet Ice Arena at 11:30 on Tuesday the 15th of October. Now, before you ask what we're doing here at this ungodly hour, is because we are here to interview Cardiff's Redhawks ice hockey team. They train between 11 p.m. and 1 a.m, so let's take a look at them in action. So we're here with Mike, the head coach of the Redhawks. Now Mike, the first question should be, why on earth are you practicing from 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. in the night?
Well, it's a good one. It's a very good question, actually. This is the only time we can get the ice. There's approximately 10, 11 teams playing at this one rink. And for a temporary rink, it's very good.
So tell us, what is the best thing about being an ice hockey player? You've been playing for 8 years?
Yeah, 8 years ice hockey, probably about 17 years in line hockey. I'd say the best thing is just the sheer aggression and the movement of the sport. It's so fast and it's so good that by the time you come off the ice, it's so knackered that you can enjoy the rest of the day then.
So anybody who's interested, how can they get involved with this?
Getting involved, send an email to the club. We're down at all the freshman's fairs, but the easiest way would be to email the club. Start with the pads, shoulder pads. They're a bit like American football pads, although there's often a little bit less plastic in there. Down the arms then, elbow pads, keep your elbows safe. It's always good to get decent ones to cover you all the way around. Gloves as well, I haven't got them on at the moment, but you need to have the gloves. Not only to have the stick, but set your hands slashed up. Moving down then, we've got these padded shorts. They're padded on the front and on the back, and they've got spinal protection at the back. They need to be nice and secure, especially if you're a defenceman. You're going to get a lot of pucks around this area. And the same with the box. You always need to have a hard box, like a cricket box.
Thank you very much to Cardiff Redhawks for taking the time to show us around.
So that's all for our first episode of CUTV All Sports. Thanks for watching, and see you in 2 weeks' time.